Hi guys and ladies, I've been tagged. Sue of Sue's Quick and Easy tagged me to do a video on what made me decide to do videos. So being the ham that I am, I'll do my best to comply. Then we'll get back to fishing and cooking. Over 4 years ago, I became intrigued by an application that came with my Mac computer. It was called iMovie. From the little I saw and read, it looked complicated, but one day I double-clicked and launched it. I was fascinated. You simply put video clips from your camera into a timeline, and I started watching YouTube videos on how to use iMovie. This looked like fun. Well, just for amusement, I managed to convert old family 8mm films and old videotapes into something that I could tinker with on my Mac. You see, I added music and subtitles and voiceovers to these old clips. I thought I was making them more engaging, I don't know. I felt these creative juices flowing. I loved weaving a story or a theme into moving pictures. I guess I loved producing something that someone might find entertaining. Maybe it was just me being entertained, but eventually I ran out of old movies to edit, so I started taking videos using my iPhone. I took a very short clip of these big grass carp swimming under the dock at my lake, and I transferred the clip to the computer and I added music and titles. No voice, but I liked it. Well, I had a YouTube account for a long time. I don't remember why I even got it. But the thought occurred to me to use it to upload my video of fish swimming under the dock just to see if anyone would look at it. Maybe it would go viral. Maybe it would be like Justin Bieber stuff. So I finally did it in 2012. It was 27 seconds long, my first video, fish swimming under a dock. And the resolution was atrocious. I had a lot to learn about videography. Really, my videos didn't get much better for a long time, especially indoor videos. Ugh, and I still grapple with problems today. You see, for me, video making wasn't about cooking or even fishing. It was about making an engaging movie. I only used fishing as an excuse to make a video. So I made a video of myself ice fishing without ice. Yes, it's possible. I knew very little about cooking. I only cooked once in a while on Saturday nights, sometimes. But soon I made a video of me making low-carb bread. That was my first cooking video, and in it, I announced that I was a novice. But that was readily apparent. The bread recipe said to punch down the risen dough. I didn't know what was meant, so I went after it with a vengeance. I mean, I pounded the bejesus out of that dough. What did I know? Nothing ever went viral. The video of the fish swimming under the dock had about 30 views after a year. I didn't care. It was a challenge to make better videos. I don't get any ad money or get paid anything for my videos. And that's probably for the best. I just want to produce a video that I could be proud of and that might entertain someone. Today, I get so many positive comments on my videos that it's really difficult to respond to everyone. That's payment enough. I can't express in words my thanks to so many people who have been so nice to me. I never expected this. Your appreciation is more than enough reward. If I can pass off a little bit of knowledge about cooking or fishing, that would be good. But if my video brings a smile to even one viewer, then for me, it's a great success. Well, if it weren't for Sue's tagging me, I would have missed this opportunity to thank everyone. Thank each of you for your support. I thank also that famous celebrity restaurant and food critic, Miss Lulu Cheeks, my frequent co-host, for putting up with my video shenanigans. Now it's time to do some hooking and cooking. then for me, it's a great success. And I snapped my neck and it made my ears ring, it's so loud.